At Mpondwe Lubiriha village, Uganda is separated from the Democratic Republic of Congo by a valley in which River Lubiriha runs. The river, a distinctive feature at the border point, is said to have been the crossing point for the rebels. On both sides of the border, eucalyptus trees stand out. It is at this point that the immediate community fetches domestic water. They also cross to the Democratic Republic of Congo, mainly for peasant farming. From the river, a small walk path leads up the hill for close to 100 meters before one can see the first homestead. Through a banana plantation, you walk another 30 meters to a second homestead where our team had left their vehicle. This is also where a clear road starts. When you are up the hill, you can clearly see the Democratic Republic of Congo laying across the deep valley. Grace Busese, a resident of Nyabuganda 2 and a retail shopkeeper who saw the rebels arrive in the area, narrates that they moved in a group of about 35 people.
It was 16th of June at 43 past 10. I was standing around the veranda. I saw armed men bypassing alongside the road. Some waved to me, me too waved to them. I asked them that, is it okay in Kiswahili? Nina sawa? They said, it's okay by use of signs. They continued going.
The school is about 200 meters from the corner house where Busese's shop is. You slope and take one more turn to the left, and in 3 minutes, you arrive at Lubiriha Secondary School. Clad in DRC camouflage army uniform, some of the rebels were completely veiled in jackets and wore army boots. They were equipped with guns, pangas, axes, hoes and sticks. The rebels arrived at the school at around 11 p.m. The first person to be killed with a panga was the gatekeeper, who was armed with a stick and a panga himself.
The school had no security. It had just only the gatekeeper. The gatekeeper was killed. He was from Ihandero, Ihandero sub-county. If I had no ammunition, any type of ammunition, not even an arrow. He had just a stick, a piece of a stick, and a panga.
They proceeded to the boys' dormitory with ease and started tricking them to open their door. The rebels used many languages, including Lingala, Kiswahili, Lunyankole, and Rukonzo.
It was 11 p.m. We had people knocking on our door, saying that open for them. We refused. And we tried to ask them, who are they? They said, this is your head teacher. We said, no, the head teacher is not around. They said, the patron, we said, no, we don't have. They said that, where the dorm captain, we said, no, don't have. That, who are here? We didn't tell them. They said, hey, nobody's here. We said, yes.
After failing to convince the boys to open the door, they proceeded to the girls' dormitory. The rebels killed all of them. Not a single girl survived. The rebels then returned to the boys' dormitory. Wilfred Ariganyira cheated death. He hid under a mattress that was later set on fire. He watched his colleagues being butchered to death one by one. He has been nursing injuries from the fire for the last 2.5 months.
So they left us because we have refused to open the door. So they went to ladies' dormitory. So the ladies, they open. So they started killing the ladies.
After like 10 minutes, they came back. They continued shooting the windows. After like in 3 minutes, they continue again hammering the door. It got broken. So they entered inside the dormitory. They started killing the students that was hammering the heads using axes, hoes, and pangas.
The murdered boys and girls were burnt beyond recognition. A family that lived close to the school could hear what was going on. They were terrified. Before they left, one of the rebels asked another called Agaba whether the job had been complete before they left. Report by Rogers Akanyijuka, Ivan Senyonjo, and Stuart Yiga for the news.